Ernie Wilkins.
Ernie Wilkins, of course, is somebody I remember for so many years with his wonderful writing for Count Basie. And he wrote a beautiful arrangement for me, big band arrangement on a tune that I wrote called Twilight World. And I understand that even since he had the stroke a couple of years ago, that he's getting better, he's out in the wheelchair and writing again.
Here's my all-time favorite, Stuff Smith.
Who?
Stuff Smith?
Stuff was a dear friend. I'll never forget when we had, you might have been there.
Oh, Stuff Smith, yes.
You know Jonah Jones?
Yes, I knew Jonah.
Jonah told me one day he was coming down Amsterdam Avenue, and this jukebox was playing like mad inside of this bar, and people were patting on, and he said, this cat came down the street, you know, Stuff. It was talking about Stuff. Stuff walked down the street, and he heard everybody in there playing, and he went and took out his fiddle and started blowing with the jukebox.
Yes.
Stuff was truly a very funny guy, and didn't seem to take things terribly seriously. But he could really play. He was a marvelous player.
He really was a marvelous player.
I see that, if I may mention, I'm in the picture. And is that Pee-wee Russell?
Pee-wee lived at my house. Pee-wee came to Boston in 1929. I was working for Leo Reisman, and he stayed at my house.
Well, Pee-wee, as you may or may not know, was terribly nervous. He was a heavy drinker, and he'd begun to drink when he was a very young man.
My mother loved him, and my mother used to, and this was in Prohibition days, and my mother they'd stay up all night drinking whiskey, and I'd say to my mother, my mother was an old little Jewish lady. I said, where did you get the whiskey? She says, I have my connections.
But he was a marvelous player, I always thought. He never knew what he was going to play, and it was always such a pleasant surprise. And I do think, really, that if they're going to be 100 years from now, we'll hear more of Pee-wee Russell's playing than of Benny Goodman's, who was truly a great artist.
Just packed up my gear. Steve and I took off, and I went back to the agency where I was working. Steve went back to his agency,
and he went on to become Art Kane, and I went on to become president of that agency.
I think after the picture was taken, we all went to Benton's Playhouse and hung around there at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and we'd go home.
Well, there were a lot of lingering conversations at the end.
We held up the actual taking of the picture for a while because Charlie Shavers wasn't there. And there was a lot of people who weren't there, but they hadn't taken we got little notices what they're going to do. We're going to take pictures of all the musicians we can get. So they didn't take it seriously. They said, oh, it's not somebody going to take a picture.
If I start counting heads and I think about how many people are no longer there anymore, it still comes as a shock to me, because we don't think about people not being here. We think about, if we think about Lester Young, we don't think, yeah, well, Lester Young was here, but he's not here anymore. Lester Young is here. Coleman Hawkins is here, you know. Roy Eldridge is here. They are in us, and they will always be alive.
It's some famous picture, huh?
It's a whole lot of people I like on here.
Mm-hmm.
I bet. Listen, I better call my wife.
A story of one man and his music. Denzel Washington stars in Spike Lee's Mo Better Blues, next on BBC Two.